The next part in this question is that why did we consider only this interval for finding out the minimum value of cos x, and why did we not take this part into consideration? Okay, so the reason behind it is that we were trying to find out the minimum value of cos x. The minimum value of cos x we were trying to find out, which we would put over here. So to find out the minimum value of cos x, we need the maximum value of x for that. Why? Because for as x increases, cos x ka value will decrease, and as x decreases, cos x ka value will increase. So to find out the maximum value of cos x, we need to find out the minimum value of x, okay, for which we found out to be 0. And why not minus pi by 3? Because minus pi by 3 and pi by 3 will hold the same meaning in terms of value. And but when we are trying to find out the minimum value will be when the x approaches its maximum value, then the cos x will have its minimum value. So x will approach its maximum value at pi by 3 according to this range, and so the minimum value for cos x will be obtained at that point only, which is cos of pi by 3. So we did this thing, and cos x was turning out to be greater than half, so we put half less than cos x less than equal to 1. So this is why the that part of the question was written in such a way. And after that it's quite easy. After that I guess it's even clear in the solution that you need to just find out the range of values of half plus cos x, like half plus cos x and then half minus cos x as per the question requires. Only this part I guess was your doubt, I guess, because this part was not even clear to was not very clear, and even I couldn't solve it. So I guess only this part was the doubt. Once this part is clear, I guess you can easily solve the further part of the question. Only the thing over here was that within this range you needed to find out the maximum and the minimum value of cos x, which turned out to be 1 and half.